Hello students, I am here again to explain one more important concept in C programming language, strings in C language. Now what is mean by string? Actually string is nothing but a group of characters. For example, consider your name. Your name is a string. Consider this message like welcome to C programming. What is this? This is again a string. Okay, whatever enclosed in double quotes, that is nothing but a string. Means string is nothing but a group of characters. Here multiple characters we are grouping together. For example, see here, these are all alphabets, then space character is there. Group of characters is nothing but a string. Now in C language we have seen multiple data types, like if you want to store whole number, then we declare variable of type integer. If we want to store any particular single character, then we can use this char data type to store single character only. Means suppose we have created one variable of type chars like ch, then what will happen inside? One byte will get reserved for this ch, and inside that we can only store one character, individual single character. Means see, if you want to store your name suppose, then we cannot store that in this character variable. Why? Because this character variable can hold only single character at a time, and there is no any inbuilt data type for storing strings in C language as well as in C++. Now what to be done here? We know the array concept. Array is what? Array is a group of similar kind of data elements, means homogeneous data elements. If you want to store multiple integers together, then what we do? We create array of integers. Now here we want to group together multiple characters. Now that character may be alphabet, that character may be space, that character may be any special symbol. Whatever available characters on the keyboards, those are considered as a characters. If we want to group together multiple characters and store somewhere, then that is only possible with the help of array concept. Okay, and means here we can use array of characters. Okay, means what? How to create array? Data type, array name, then in square bracket we have to mention size. Now see, this size will represent how many elements are there in that array. Now suppose I want to create any character array, then what should be done here? How to create that character array? Data type is char, name of that character array is let str, and we can write here like in square bracket 30. Then what does it mean? This str is an character array that will hold 30 characters in it. This is nothing but character array. But every character array, we cannot say that that is a string. Means character array and string, both are same as well as both are different. How? See, what is string exactly? String is nothing but a group of characters, or you can say that array of characters, that is terminated by /0. This is very much important point, that is terminated by /0. This /0 is nothing but a null character. That /0 is called as a null character. Okay, now we have seen what is strings. Now here, string is nothing but a group of characters or set of characters or array of characters that should be terminated by /0. Means this /0 indicates end of string. If any character array is not having /0 at the end, then we cannot call it as a string. If any character array is having only characters like A, B, C, D, E, then that is not the string. If any character array is ending with that /0, then only we can say that that is a string. Now see what is the difference between this character array and string. For that we will see some examples how to initialize string. That first we will see how to initialize string. Now in a C language, whenever I have explained that concept, that literal means string literal, character literal, integer literal means constant. Integer constant normally specified like this, 5, 6, 8 in that way. If we are writing like 1.5, 1.7, that will be the double constant. If I want to store any character, then how we mention that character? Whatever enclosed in double quotes, that is nothing but a character. Now suppose I am enclosing this, writing in this way. This is what? This is not integer. This is a character, because if we are not writing this single quote, then this is a integer value. If we are enclosing anything in single quote, then that will be the character. Now, in the same way, whatever enclosed in double quotes, that will be considered as a string. Suppose I am writing like this. We normally write in printf statement whatever enclosed in double quotes. Suppose I want to give message like enter any number. Then how we write? In printf, we write like this. Printf in double quotes, enter a or first number, in that way. In this way we write. Now what is this? We have enclosed everything in double quote. This is nothing but a string. String. Now see how to initialize string. That we have to see now. Here first we have to write like char. Name of that string is let s. Here I am writing like 10. This is what? This is how to declare character array. That is nothing but string. Now here I am writing like this in double quotes. See, I am writing that e logic. Here I have mentioned whatever in double quotes, that is nothing but a string, and that I am assigning to this character array. Now what will happen internally? Here see, we have given size as a 10, and for that 10 bytes will get allocated in a memory, and that is contiguous allocation we have seen, because this is what? This is array. Array elements are stored contiguously inside a memory. Contiguous means one after other, next, 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 and so on. The addresses are continuous. Okay, now here 10 bytes will get reserved, 1, 2, 3 up to 10. 10 bytes will get reserved in a memory, and here I am storing a logic string. Now how it will get stored? In this way, E, L, O, G, I, C, all individual characters, and at the end automatically that slash 0 will be inserted. This slash 0 will get automatically attached at the end of that string, because we have written this one in double quotes, means automatically that character array will be considered as a string. Getting? Now in this way the memory allocation for this one. Now see, if we are initializing it, any array at the time of declaration, if we are initializing, then this is not compulsory, means giving size is not compulsory in that case. Means here there is no any compulsion to write size. Now what will happen in that case? It will calculate how many characters are there. Here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 characters are there, and one more character is there, that is slash 0. That's why it will allocate space for only 7 characters. The size of S will be automatically computed as 7, and in that case only 7 bytes will get reserved for that array, and in this way the internal structure will be. Now here addresses are again contiguous, like let address of this first character is 100. Then of course here 101, 102, and so on. Getting? In this. Now what we have seen? This string is an array of characters or group of characters that is terminated by slash 0. Whatever enclosed in double quotes, that will be considered as a string. Now next is how to initialize string. The first way we have seen like this. We can write this character array, means in the same way just like we declare any array. And here is equal to, after equal to we have to give some values, and here we have given one string which is enclosed in double quotes. In this way we can initialize a string. The second way of initializing string, that is like this. We have to write in this way, like char s, again same name I am using, equals to this one, or we can use this way, is equals to. Normally how we initialize array? We just put open close curly brace, and in that comma separated we give elements. In the same way also we can initialize this string, but here compulsory you have to put this slash 0 at the end, then only this will be considered as a string. Here automatically size will be computed. Here I am not mentioning any size, no problem will be there. Automatically the size will be computed according how many elements you have given here. Now here if you have written this one, that is slash zero character at the end, then only this S will be considered as a string. Otherwise this will be considered as only array of characters. This is the difference. See if I am not writing this, then what will happen? No problem will be there, but this S will be considered as a character array, not as a string. This is the difference between string and character array. Here you have to compulsory write slash zero at the end. Getting? Now, whatever internal structure, whatever memory allocation, that is just like this one. No any difference. Now the next point, how to accept a string? We have seen if we want to accept something in C programming, then we use scanf. If we want to display something, then we use printf. Here, if you want to accept any string from user, then you can also use that scanf. Again, if you want to display something, then we can use here printf, no problem will be there. And in that scanf and printf, we have to use format specifier, because that scanf and printf are formatted IO functions. If we are accepting any integer, then which format specifier we use? %d format specifier. If we are accepting any character, then we have to use %c. For floating point value, we use %f. In the same way, for accepting any string or displaying any string with the help of printf and scanf, we have to use again format specifier, and that will be %s format specifier we have to use. Let I want to accept name of a student, then we will declare one character array for that first. How? Let char, then name, and here in square bracket we mention size. For example, let I am writing here 30. 30, I am just considering size of that character array, maximum number of characters. Here this string is capable of holding maximum 29 characters, not 30, because the last one space, whatever byte, that should be there for termination, means for slash zero character, that is a null character. Now see how to accept string. Here we have to give message like enter your name. Okay, through printf we can give message like printf enter your name in this way. Now how to accept? We can use using scanf. Scanf here, normally in scanf, first we write whatever format specifier in double quotes. Same I have written here, I have used %s. And see what is the difference here. I am writing here just name. Normally in scanf, what we use here? Ampersand. Okay, because ampersand is to get address of that variable. But here I am not writing ampersand. Why? This is what array name. Actually we are creating array here to store the string. Array name itself holds its base address, means in the array name itself there is an address. That's why again don't write here ampersand, because this name is what, this is the name of this character array and this is holding address in it. That's why again don't put that ampersand, otherwise you will get error. Means just keep in mind, whenever you are accepting any string with the help of scanf, then use %s format specifier and don't use ampersand. Just write here whatever name of that variable, that is here name. Getting? Here you can write also yes name for student name. Any variable name you can use by following identifier rules. Now see, this is the first way by which you can accept a string. Now one more way is there, that is a getS function. We have already covered that getS function in formatted IO functions and unformatted IO functions, whatever we have learned. Now see, to accept a string with the help of getS function, what is the syntax? See, getS we have to write, means instead of scanf we can use getS. GetS, and here only you have to put that variable name. This is very easy. Okay, now here getS is what? It is unformatted IO function, that's why don't use that %s. Okay, formatted IO function, this one, scanf, means formatted input function. Now here we have to compulsory write %s, but getS, here don't write anything, just put here whatever variable name. Here S name is a name of that array. Now what is the difference in between these two? See, if we are accepting any string with the help of scanf, then we cannot enter string having spaces. Means if you want to enter full name, if you want to accept full name of a student, then you cannot use this scanf. Keep in mind. Okay, for accepting string having white spaces, compulsory use this getS function. If you want to only accept first name of that student, then you can use easily this scanf. But if you know that string may have spaces in it, then space means white space. Like this, enter after that space. This type of string, if you want to accept having spaces like full name of a student, it will have spaces, of course. First name, then space, then middle name, then space, then last name. That type of string you can accept only with the help of getS. Now why? Because scanf function will consider white space as a terminator. Means whenever it will scan that whatever input user is entering, whenever it will get that space, then it will think like, now this is the end of string. Means that's white space or enter key. Okay, these are two. Means white space or enter key will be the terminator for this scanf functions. That's why you cannot enter string having spaces using scanf. You cannot enter. But getS is capable of accepting string having white spaces. No problem will be there, because here only if you press enter key, then only that enter key will be considered as a terminator for getS. Getting? This is the difference between scanf and getS. And this scanf is formatted input function and this getS is unformatted. Now how to display string? For that, again same thing. For displaying string, we can use either printf, or second way is use putS. Okay, two ways are there. How to use that? See, whatever accepted through this scanf, I want to display onto the output screen, then what we will write? Here we can write like printf. See, I want to give like welcome message to that student. Welcome percent s. In this way I can use. Whatever value of that s name, it will display. Now here there is no any restriction like this scanf. Means if any string is having white spaces, then that type of string also easily displayed with the help of this printf. No problem will be there. This printf percent s, means using percent s format specifier with the help of printf function, we can easily display string, any type of string. No any restriction on that string should not have white space or not like that. One more way is to display string onto the output screen, that is simple putS, just like that, is a counterpart of getS. Now putS, now how to use that? PutS and just write here. Now see, suppose you want to display like welcome and then sname, then both instructions you have to write separately. Means first you can write like putS welcome, and then you can write that putS sname in this way. Okay, now here what will happen? See, what is the difference between in these two? Let I am not writing this welcome. Let then what is the difference between these two? Here we have to write that percentage comma yes name. Instead of printf, we can use putS to display the string. Now how it will act? Now what is the difference? Now we can use printf or putS. Printf is again a formatted output function. Here you have to compulsory use percentage. And second, putS, here there is no need to use any format specifier, because this is an unformatted output function for string. What is the difference now? Whenever you display any string with the help of printf, then what will happen? It will displace. Let in sname there is Pallavi. Okay. Now what will happen here? That Pallavi will get stored inside memory. Whenever we display like this with the help of printf, then what will happen? It will display whatever contents of that S name, and cursor will remains on the same line. See, if we are displaying string with the help of printf, it will display whatever contents of that S name. Now consider here, let contents of that S name are Pallavi. Now it will display that, and cursor will remains on the same line. Means after this, if you have written any printf statement, then it will display whatever message here only, on the same line. If you want to shift that cursor to the new line, you have to explicitly put that slash n. Means here you can put that slash n, like slash n, and then S name. Means here automatically cursor will get shifted here because of this slash n. Getting? Means you have to put this one explicitly. After displaying S name, cursor will remains on the same line if we are using printf for displaying string. And instead of that, if we are using put S, then that cursor will get automatically shifted to new line. Means after displaying that string, it will display whatever contents of S name and automatically shift that cursor to the new line. Getting? This is the concept, means how to accept string and display string. For accepting string, we can use either scanf or get S. For displaying string, we can use printf with format specifier percent S or put S. Getting? Now, what are the differences? Using scanf, you cannot enter string having white spaces. Using getS, you can enter string having white spaces. And what is the difference between printf and putS? If you are using printf to display string, then after displaying that string, cursor will remains on the same line. If you want to shift that to the new line, you have to explicitly put there slash n. If you are displaying string with the help of putS, then after displaying that string, cursor will get automatically shifted to the new line. Now see, the next point I'm going to explain, that is string functions. Those string functions are present in string.h header file. If you want to use inbuilt string oriented functions, then compulsory include string.h header file for that. Now what are those functions? Let us see one by one. The first function is strlen. Now see, this function you can use to find length of a string. Okay, to get how many characters are there in a string, it will return length of string. Length of string means number of characters present in that string. It will not means count that slash zero character, because every string is having slash zero at the end. But while counting, it will not count that slash zero character, this strlen function. Now, what is the prototype of this function that I am going to explain? See, normally how we use this strlen function. First see, let in main, I have declared one variable. Here, one string variable, like char str, and here I am putting square bracket is equal to let welcome. In this way. Okay, now see, here I am not giving any size, it is optional, not compulsory, because if you are initializing the string at the time of declaration, then this is not compulsory to mention the size of that character array. Now here I want to calculate how many characters are there in that string, then we can use this strlen function. Now for that, we have to first include here that string.h. Again, we have to include that stdio.h, that is again compulsory, right? Now see, here I want to calculate length of that string. Length of string means what? Number of characters. Number of characters is always an integer value. For that, we'll declare one variable integer, let l. Now inside that l, I want to calculate length of this string. Now how to calculate? Just use that inbuilt function, that is strlen. How? strlen, and in bracket we can write name of that string. Name of that string means name of that character array, that is str. Now what will happen here? It will calculate how many characters are there. Now here 7 characters are there, and it will return that 7 value and will store inside l. And now just we have to display that with the help of printf, like printf length of string is, or length is equal to, we have to write percent d because it is integer value, and just write l. This is how we can use that strlen function, which is inbuilt function present in the string.h header file, to calculate length of a string. We see this strlen function is present in this file which is already written. Now how it is written, what is the function declaration part for that function, whatever written by the language itself, that we have to see now. And that is called as prototype of that function. Okay, it is called as a prototype. Prototype will represent what is the function signature, means how it is internally. It will mention what is the return type, what is the name of the function, and what type of argument you have to pass to that function. This is nothing but calling function. We are here calling that str alien function, which is already present, already written. Whenever we use function concept, then there are three aspects basically: function, declaration, definition, and call. But here there is no need to declare or define because it is already defined in this file. We will directly use it. Okay, and this is nothing but we are calling that str alien function. Now see here, prototype represents the return type, function name, and which type of argument it will have. Here return type will be of course integer, because return means how many number of characters it will count, and that value it will return outside from that function. The return type is integer. Then function name is str alien, and here what I am passing, see, string str. Str is what? It is a character array, and here I am passing name of that string. Name of that array will hold address. Of course there should be a pointer variable to cache that address. Means whenever we pass array to the function, then here in this part there should be a pointer. Means we can pass array to the function with the help of either pointer or with the help of subscript operator that we have already covered in that function lesson. Internally again the same thing is there. There is a one const char star type pointer. Why pointer? Because here I am passing array. This str is what? Str is array. Whenever we are passing array, there should be one pointer of the same type. Here the char, here again char. Now here why const? Because this function is only calculating length of that string, means only counting, means number of characters from that string, and will return. It will not change that string whatever we are passing, and that's why if it is not allowed to change, then we have to attach const keyword for that. That's why here const char star, this is the argument. This is the name of the function str-alien, and it will calculate how many characters are there. It will count number of characters excluding that slash zero and will return that integer value. This is the prototype of str-alien function which is inbuilt. Now we have to write our own function for doing the same. How to do that? Just see. Okay, we can do in this way. See, I will give name as a my str-alien, because str alien is already inbuilt, which is present. My str alien we can give now, because same name we cannot give. Here return type will be integer, function name I am giving like my str alien, and here const, same thing I will apply here, char star let s, and this is just a function declaration. Now I want to write my own function definition. How to write? Same way, int my str alien, then const char star s, and here I have to write code to calculate length of this string. Now how to calculate? See, this is in memory. Now see str here, how many bytes will get allocated? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Because 1 for slash 0. This size will be automatically computed, that is 8. And 8 bytes will get allocated in a memory like this here, see. And here that string will get stored. And last one is slash 0. Now see, this is what, this is a str, this is an array. Of course this is what first element we can fetch using str of 0, then str of 1, just like array. Getting? Because this is internally, this is array. And how to fetch array elements using index? Like index starts with 0 and ends with size minus 1, in that way. Here the size of this array is 8, that's why index will from 0 to 7. Now see, I want to calculate how many characters are there in this string. We have to count how many characters are there. See, we will apply here some logic. Here we are passing, we are calling that str alien function. Here I will write like this, my str alien, and here I will pass str in this way. Now see, this str is nothing but name of this array. Name of array means it will hold base address of that array. Means here address is initially let 100, here 101, 102, and so on. Now here I am passing 100. 100 is nothing but address, And for that here there should be a pointer variable to catch that address. Now inside yes, what will be there? Inside yes, there is a 100 value. Getting my what? I am passing that str. Str is nothing but name of that array, and that is holding base address that I am passing, and that will be cached inside this edge. Now using this yes, we can fetch this array now. And now we will calculate. We can calculate here length of that string. Now till I am not getting this slash zero, we have to move forward, and we will set there one counter variable. Initial value will be zero. If this character is slash zero, then stop. If it is not, then count plus plus. Okay, means how we will do? See, we will check first this character. Is it slash zero? No. Then count plus plus. Again, this is it slash zero? No. Then again count plus plus. In this way, we will move forward, and whenever we will get this slash zero character, we will stop. And in that way, we can get count, that is number of characters in that cnt variable. Getting? Now how to do that? See, return type is integer, function name mystralien, and here const char star s. Now here why this one? Because I am passing here str. Str is what? Array name. Array name itself holds its base address. Whenever we are passing any array, then we have to catch it in pointer variable. Why? Because arrays are passed by reference always. We have seen that everything in function concept. What we have to do now? We have to check whether this one is slash zero. No, then count plus plus. Means still we are not getting this slash zero character. We have to do counting process repeatedly, and that's why we will use here loop. First, we will declare one counter variable. Let int cnt equals to zero. How we will write here? While star s not equal to slash zero. See what I am doing? Cnt plus plus and s plus plus. S is holding now 100. Star s means what? Star 100. That is nothing but w. Okay. Is it slash zero? No. Then increment the counter. That is cnt plus plus. Initially cnt is having value zero. Now cnt will become one. Now again I have written here s plus plus. S plus plus means what? S is what? Pointer. In pointer we can do that increment. No problem will be there. Now s will become 101. I am modifying here that s pointer. It is possible. No problem will be there. Now see, s will become, because of this s plus plus, s will become 101. Why? S plus plus means what? S equals to s plus 1. Now s is what? Pointer variable. Whenever we are doing that plus plus or plus 1, whatever operations on pointer, then this is not just normal arithmetic. Normal means s is 100 and 100 plus 1 is 101. That is not like this. Actually the logic is s plus 1 into size of char. Getting? Now your size of char is again 1, that's why we will get here 101, and that will again stored inside this s. This is the logic only. Now here in s, what is 101? Now again control will come here and we'll check star s. Star s means star 101, means value at 101 is e, not equal to slash 0, it is true. If it is true, it will again go inside that loop and will execute the statement. Now cnt plus plus, cnt will become 2, and s plus plus again it will become 102, and so on. In this way, finally whenever s is here 1, 0, 3, 4, 5, whenever s will become 107, at that time counter will become 7. And here 107 means star 107, we will get slash 0. And at that time, here this condition will become false. Control will automatically come out of that while loop, because this condition is false now. Because star s is not equal to slash 0 is false, because star s is slash 0 now at the end. And that's why control will be here and cnt value will become 7. Now we have to return that cnt from this function. and for that we will use that return keyword, return cnt. Yes, getting? Instead of this s plus plus we can use that I counter, means we will do like this. See, instead of that we can write code like this. Here we have to declare one more integer variable. Let it is initially it should be 0, and here instead of star s we will write like this, while star s plus I not equal to slash 0. In that way also we can do the same thing, cnt plus plus and then I plus plus. Now here see what is the difference in between these two. Here every time we are modifying that s, but here we are not modifying that s. S will remains always 100. We will only add something and we will get value at that location. Getting? Means here s will be, now here you can write that const, no problem will be there. In that case you have to do this I plus plus every time, and here we are just changing, modifying that pointer itself. That is okay, no problem will be there. Now here we have catched that in L and we will display whatever length of that string. Getting? This is how to write our own function for doing the same task just like strlen. Getting? Now the next function present in this string.h header file is strcpy. strcpy stands for copy one string to any other string. Suppose any one string is having some contents, then same contents if you want to copy inside any other string, then we can do that with the help of this strcpy function. To use this function we have to compulsory include this string.h header file in our program. Okay, now it is used to copy one string to other. Now what is the prototype of this strcpy function? It is returning one char star value. Actually what this strcpy will do, strcpy will take that source string and all the characters from that source string it will put inside this target string, and whatever target string whatever formed that it will return again. Means it will do both. It will just copy the contents of that source string into target string, and as well as it will return that target string. Means actually it is returning the address of that string. Okay, whatever target string, that's why here we have written char star as a return type. That I will explain with the help of example why it is returning that char star. Now see here how to use this strcpy function. First we have to include that string.h header file in our program, that is compulsory. Then we will write that void main. After that see, let one string I have I will here declare, like let char s1. I am not mentioning here size, no problem will be there because I am assigning here value. Okay, if you want to accept that string from user then compulsory mention here size. Here I am writing like elogic. This is what, this is a string. There is one more character array s2 having size 10 suppose. Okay, now I want to copy this string into this one, then how to do that? Just call this strcpy function. How? We will write like this strcpy. First we have to write target, means in which you want to copy that string you have to mention as a first argument to that strcpy. In s2 I want to copy the contents of s1, that's why this one is a target and this one is a source, that's why I write s2 then s1, that's it. Now after doing this, after doing this, if you are displaying whatever contents of s2, then you will get same contents like s1. Getting? This is nothing but how to copy contents of one string into other. Always keep in mind you have to first give here target string, means destination, and then source string. This format you have to apply. Now here how to display, put as we can use here to display contents of that s2. After execution of this program we will get elogic displayed onto the output screen. Here actually we are displaying s2. S2 is having again the same thing just like s1, because we have copied contents of s1 into s2 here. Now see what is the use of this char star. Now See, I am not catching whatever this function is returning here. Actually, I am not catching. I am just calling that function. See, we have seen whenever a function is returning something, we will catch it. But here I am not catching whatever it is returning. Actually, it is returning target string. But no need to catch. Then here there may be void. But why they have provided this structure? Why they have returned that target? See, I want to calculate number of characters in that target string. Then we can use in this way. See, after displaying that S2, I will find out like this. Let there is one integer variable. Let int x. I can write like this. X is equals to strlen, and in S2, in this way we can use strlen function. No problem will be there, and after that we will display value of x. Instead of that, see, I am writing here only x equals to strlen and then this strcpy. This function will copy source string into target string and will return that target string. Getting? Means strcpy function, what it will do? It will do that, it will copy whatever contents of S1 into S2 and will return again that S2, whatever formed. Now here what is there? S2 is there. And again we are just calling strln function on that S2. Then it will count the number of characters in that S2 and will get stored inside S. Means both functions we can call here, multiple functions we can call here in cascading style. Getting? Means first function, then next function. In cascading style we can use this function. Now we have to write our own function for doing same task. See how to, what is the logic here? See, instead of this strcpy, I will write my strcpy. Now my strcpy, we have to write. Okay, and for that string.h header file, don't include that. No need. Why? Because I am not using that built-in function. I am going to write my own function here. How to write? Just see the logic first, then I will write the function. Logic is like this. Let S1 string is in this way, in a memory. S1 is E L O G I C and one more character here, there is slash 0. Getting? This is our S1. Now S2 is there in a memory. Again S2 is having 10 size here, because we have written here S2 in square bracket 10. That's why 10 bytes will get reserved. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. My strcpy function I have called, what it should do? It should copy this character inside this one, then this one into here, this one here. In this way it should do. Now what we will do here, how to fetch this character? Suppose I am passing here S2 comma S1. S2 means array name. Here again I am passing this whole array, means actually we are passing here base address of this S2 and here S1. Now in that function we will catch that in pointers, okay, and with the help of those pointers we can fetch these characters like star S1 plus I in that way, or star S1. Means still we are not getting this slash 0, we have to copy this character here, then this character here. Do this process till we are not getting slash 0. Now here what is the return type of this mystrcpy function? The return type will be again same thing, just like a built-in function we will do. Char star, then function name is mystrcpy. Here we will pass two character stars. Okay, char star. First is here I have written S2S1. Here we can write S2S1 or any other name also we can use for formal arguments. But this S2S1 will be different, this S2S1 will be different. Getting? I will use here same thing because here I have used this S1 and S2. S2 comma, or we can write here target for T and then char star source. For source I will use S. Now we have to write code. We will scan this whole string. We will go through this whole string till it is not, we are not getting slash 0. We have to do this task here. Now here we can write like this, while that star S here, which is the, this S1 is inside S, S will hold base address of this 100, and here T will hold, let it is 200. In this way the internal structure will be. Here we are passing first S2 means here 200 will get stored inside this T. Similarly S1 we are passing, and S1 will hold 100, that will get stored inside this S. Now while star S, now we can modify this, but see, if we are modifying this T, then again at the end we have to return that target, and at that time we will get problem, because T will become like this, it will hold the address of the last character. Then in that case we may get problem. That's why we can use that same style like plus I, okay, that we will follow here. Now here we will declare one variable, let I initially 0 star S plus I not equal to slash 0, means still this one is not equal to slash 0. S plus I means what? That character is not equal, star S plus I means character at that address is not equal to slash 0. We have to do this process. What we should do? Here T is having 200. At this place I want to copy this E. What I am doing here? Star T plus I means T is having 200. I is 0. 200 plus 0 means 200. Star means value at that location is equal to star S plus 0 means star 100 plus 0 means E. E will get copied here because of this statement. Getting? Now next we have to change value of I because we have to move forward. That's why we will do I plus plus. This is only the logic. Now what will happen here? See, some points or some statements are remaining here. Now see, here E will get copied here first, then I plus plus, I will become 1. In that case it will fetch this L. L will get copied here again. Then I plus plus, it will copy O. I plus plus, it will copy G. I C, but it will not copy that slash 0. Why? Because whenever it is getting that slash 0, it will come out of that loop. That's why slash 0 not copied here. Now we have to explicitly put that slash 0 here. We have to put. Now I will hold the proper value that we can use to put here that character. Now here we have to explicitly write like star T plus I equals to slash 0 at the end. Why? See, initially I is 0 here. Here I will become 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now I is 6. At that time this condition will become false and we will come out of that loop. Now I is 6. Now I have written star T plus I. T is having 200 plus 6, we will get 206, because one character space we will get added. Means star 206 equals to slash 0 means what? Which location? This one. It will put here slash 0, this statement. Getting? Now this character array, we can say it is as a string. If we are not putting this slash 0, this will not be considered as a string. This is, we have to strictly follow this. Now here we have to compulsory attach here slash 0 using this statement. Now this string has copied inside this one. Now we have to return that destination, means target string. Simple, return whatever target string's base address, means target string we have to return. Simple T, don't write star. We have to return the target string, means array name we have to return here. Getting? And that is nothing but T. T will hold again 200. That will get returned here. Getting? Now finally we have to return T as a target string. In this way we can write our own function to do same task, like just like strcpy. Now see, strcat, this is a inbuilt function present again in string.h header file that we can use to concatenate two strings. Concatenation means attaching two strings to each other. okay, that is for concatenation, or you can say that it is used to append one string to other. Append means what? Attaching at the end. Okay, whatever destination string we have given, source string will get attached to the destination string, and that destination string will get written. Destination means target string. Now to append one string to other, or you can write here concatenates source string to the target string. Getting this strcat function can be used to concatenate source string to the target string at the end. See, at the end it will attach. Now what is the prototype? Here see, again this string will concatenate two string. Concatenate means just attaching two strings, but it will not change the source string. It will only change the target string, and that's why it will whatever change string, whatever target string, it will return again. That's why return type will be again char star. Function name is strcat. Here we have to pass two strings. Source string will gets attached to the target string. Now here first argument you have to pass like char star target. Target is going to be modified here. That's why here const keyword is not there. But in source there is a const keyword, like const char star source. Now see, this strcat function can be used to attach the source string at the end of target string. That is nothing but concatenation, or you can say appending source to the target. Appending means attaching at the end, and whatever formed string, whatever target string, that will gets again return. That's why return type is char star. Now how to use this function, just I am going to explain with example. See, we will declare here two strings, two character arrays. Let char s1 is equal to c hello, and s2 is students. Hello is already there in this s1. I want to attach this s2 to s1, then we will get hello students in this s1. I am using that strcat function c. In this way, strcat string concatenation, first I have to write target string, means to which I want to attach. That is nothing but s1 and then s2. Now here s1 only s1 will gets modified. S1 only will be modified, s2 will be as it is. We are attaching s2 to s1, and it will return s1. This is the prototype. Now after calling this strcat function, if we are displaying both like s1 and s2, then what are the contents here? Let put as s1 and put as s2. Now what will be the output here? See, here s1 is hello, s2 is students. Strcat s1 comma s2 means it, this s2 string, whatever student string, will gets attached to s1, means s1 will become hello students and s2 will not modify. That's why the second argument here, there is a const. Getting? Because s2 will remains as it is, source string will be as it is. There is no any modification in source, only modification is in target. Now see what will be the output here. Put as s1, it will display hello students, and here put as s2, it will display students. Getting? In this way, we can use strcat function to attach any string to any other string at the end. That is nothing but concatenation of two strings. It is not just like we are attaching two strings, hello and students, here together, and it is returning whatever. See, somewhere you may get a statement like this. Let we have written in this way strcpy. There is one more character array. Let char s of let 30. See, suppose I have written like this strcpy s comma. Here I am using both the string functions together in a single statement. That is possible only because this function is just concatenating S2 to S1. Also, it is returning whatever S1. Getting? After attaching to S1, it will return S1 and whatever string inside that S1. Now it is in hello students. That will get copied inside S. Means after this, if you are displaying that S, then you will get again hello students. Getting? Now how to write that function? See, return type will be char star name is mystrcat. Here we have to pass two arguments. Okay, see, first argument char star target, and see, we will write T only, no problem. Char star S. I have written like this, S1 is equals to hello. Now here size is what? Automatically the size of this S1 is will get set as a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. In the previous example also we will get some error here because size it is it can hold only 6 characters. And here we are attaching S2 to S1. Everything will work fine, only we have to do one change there, like S1 here we have to set size, let it is 20. Somewhat maximum size you have to put. This should be there, then only you will not get error. Otherwise, if we are not writing anything, that means what? Automatically size will get computed like 6. And here suppose you want to attach something, then you cannot do that. Getting? And that's why you have to set size of that S1 as some maximum size. Because we are not copying, we are just attaching here something. Now what should be done here? In from that T, we have to go forward, we have to traverse till we are getting this character. And from this here, we have to copy this character. Means first we have to move this T here. Getting? We have to go forward at this place. Means what should be written here in the same? Here we will take one variable here, I. Okay, we can also modify that T, but finally we have to return that T. And that's why we will not modify here. I equals to 0. Now what should be done here? Tell me. See, while star T plus I not equal to slash 0, we will do that I plus plus. Star T plus I not equal to slash 0, we will do that I plus plus. Only one statement will be there in this file. Now what will happen here? I will become, because of this statement, I will become, see here I is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Getting? Now here I is 6 at the end. And this loop will get terminated because now I is 6 here and value of that character is slash 0. That's why it will come out of that while. And there is only single statement in this while. That's why we can skip that brace. No problem will be there. Now I is having 6 value. Now here I want to copy this. For that we will take one more counter. J equals to 0. Because from here we have to move from this position to forward. Now we will take one J variable, J counter. Now what should be done here? See, again I will start from this and up to this character till I am not getting slash 0. We have to copy this content here, then this content here. Getting? Now what should be done? See, I will write like this. While star S plus J not equal to slash 0, means while this character is not equal to slash 0, we have to move forward, and before that we have to copy this character here, then this character here, in this way. Means what? Star T plus I equals to star S plus J. For this string, for traversing this string we will use J counter. For traversing this string we will use I counter. Now see, simple. Here after copying this S here, we have to change, we have to modify value of I, that I should become 7 and J should become 1. Getting? I plus plus and J plus plus. Getting? In this way we have to do this concatenation. Now finally, after copying this S, we will get slash 0 and control will automatically get out of that loop. Now we have to explicitly attach this slash 0 at the end here, because this slash 0 has replaced by S, then T, then here. In this way all characters will get copied, finally S will get copied, and now here I will have the proper value of this location at the end. Now here only we have to put that slash 0. What should be written here? Slash 0. Then give semicolon, and finally we have to return that target. Getting? Return T. That's it. This is only the code for this mystrcat. Now how it will work? See, initially counter I and j will be 0. I is counter I am using for this T target string. J counter I am using for this source string. Till I am not getting slash 0, here we have to move forward. We will increment that counter I so that we will get this place. After getting this place, I will, now my work is copy this string here. Means we are attaching this string here. J, it is initially 0 star S plus 0, that should get copied here. That means star T plus I. And every time we will increment that I counter and J counter, and finally we have to attach here slash 0 character. And that's why I have written this statement, like star T plus I equals to slash 0. And finally we have to return this target string. That's why return T. Getting? In this way we can write our own function for doing the same task, just like strcat. Now see, the next function that is present in string.h header file is strcmp. Here this function can be used to compare two strings. Okay, to compare two strings we can use this function. Now what is the prototype here? See, here this function is returning one integer value, then function name is strcmp. Here two strings we are comparing, that's why we will pass here two strings. It will return the difference between ASCII values of first non-matching character. Means what? Let S1 string is there, like char S1 equals to let hello, and let S2, char S2 is also hello suppose. Now here it will return the difference between first non-matching character. Here there is no any non-matching character, that's why it will return 0. Means if both the strings are equal, if S1 is equal to S2, then it will return 0. See, if I have written like this, first string is like hello and second is let hello and space students. I want to compare these two strings, then what this function, what it will return? It will return difference between ASCII value of first non-matching character. Now what does it mean? See, it will check the first character is H, here again same, here A, E same, L same, L same, O same. Now here the last character is slash 0 and here the character is space. Now this one is a non-matching character. Here there is slash 0 and here there is space. Now this one is the first non-matching character. Now what this function will return? Slash 0, the ASCII value of slash 0 is 0, ASCII value of space is 32. It will return 0 minus 32, that is minus 32. In this way, this my strcmp function will not only check whether both are equal or not, not like that. If this function is returning difference between first non-matching character, if that difference is 0, then both are same. If difference is not equal to 0, then both are different. In this way, now here there is slash 0 because this is the last character, and here after O there is space. This one is first non-matching character, it will return minus 32. Means whenever this S1 is less than S2, now that's why it will return negative value in this case. Getting? Now see, if it is like this, the first is hello and second string is like welcome. Now here the first character is only the non-matching character. What is the ASCII value of H? It will get. What is the ASCII value of W? It will get, and it will return the difference. Now W is greater than H, means S2 is greater than S1. Here again it will return negative value. if the difference, let this is S1 and this is S1 and this is S2, means here S1 is greater than S2. In this case, what it will return? See, it will return difference between W and H, and that is positive value, because W is greater than H. W is after H, that's why W will have greater value, greater ASCII value than H, that's why it will return positive. Means in this way, this strcmp function will work. And if strcmp function has returned zero value, then of course we can say there that both strings are equal, otherwise different. Okay, how to do that? See the example here. In main, we will accept two strings from user and we will check whether both strings are equal or not. How? For that, again we have to include that string.h header file. It is compulsory. Void main, here two character arrays we will declare to accept two strings from user. First one is let char s1 of 10, then char s2 of 10. In the same line also you can declare both the arrays by giving comma in between that. Now see, I will write like printf enter first string. Now we have to accept that string, we can use get s. Okay, get s s1. Similarly, printf enter second string. Now we will accept that string with the help of again get s, like get s s2. Okay, now see, here we have accepted both the strings. Now I want to compare those strings. Then how we can use this strcmp function? See, here we have to pass two arguments to this strcmp function. That is nothing but both the strings, and it will return either zero or non-zero value. Here we can write in if directly, if strcmp s1 comma s2 is equal to zero. Getting? Means if this function is returning zero value, means both strings are equal. Just printf equal. Otherwise, else printf different. Getting? This is only the program to compare two strings with the help of strcmp function. If you want to check what is the value this strcmp function is returning, then just declare one variable like integer, let l, and here write l equals to strcmp s1 comma s2, then you will get idea about what this function is returning. Okay, and just display value of l, then you will get what is the difference between first non-matching character, it is giving or not, you can check it out. This is strcmp function we can use to compare two strings. Now some more functions are there, like strrev, that can be used to reverse the string. Okay, how to use it? I am just here explaining. Suppose the string is like elogic. After reversing it, you will get cigole, this type of string. If we are applying this str reverse function on this string, then we will get this type of string, whatever reverse contents of that string. First C will be there, then I, then G, O, L, E, in that way. Getting? See, the prototype is like this. Here the return type is the string whatever reversed as it is, that is char star, name is strrev, and here again I am passing char star, not const. Only one string I am passing, because only one string we want to reverse. It will reverses the string whatever we have passed, and also returning that string, both it will do. See, suppose I have written code like this, void main, let there is s1 and it is having elogic, and I have written like this strrev s1 only, and after that I am displaying that s1, put as s1. Now tell me what you think here, what you will get? Reverse string. You are passing something to this strrev function and it will return reverse string, but the source string, whatever you are passing, that will be as it is, not like that. Always keep in mind this point. It will reverses the string itself, whatever you are passing, that will gets modified. And again it will return also the modified string. That's why here you will get reverse string. Somewhere there may be a statement like this. There is a S2 having size 10. Okay, and I have written here strcpy S2 comma in this way. Str reverse S1. And they ask like this. Put S, S1 and S2. Then you can think like this. In S1 we will get e-logic. And in S2 we will get reverse string. You can think like this. You will get same string in both. Okay. Now on the basis of that, there is one question. That is, write a program to accept a string from user and check whether it is palindrome or not. That question is always asked everywhere, in examination, in interview, everywhere. That is very much important question. Program to accept a string from user and we have to check whether it is palindrome or not. What is the concept of palindrome? This is applicable for strings as well as numbers. Whether number is palindrome or not means, let the number is like this, 1, 2, 1. Then this one is a palindrome number. Why? Because the number and its reverse both are same. Then you can say that the number is palindrome number. In the same way, the string is like, let the string is like Nitin. See, if you are reversing it, then you will get same string. Then that type of string is called as a palindrome string. Otherwise, it is not palindrome. That we have to check here. Now for that we can use that strrev function, reverse. Okay. Now for that we have to include string.h. It is compulsory because I am going to use here that inbuilt function. You can write your own logic also, some different logic also. But here I am using that strrev function which is inbuilt in string.h header file. Hash include that string.h. Now the second, we have to include that stdio.h again to accept and display. Okay. Now next, what should be done here? Void main, we have to accept the string from user first. Okay. Now, for that we will declare one character, let s of 20. Now here, one more character array we will declare. Let C for copy of that string. See what logic we will apply here. See, in S we will accept that string. Whatever. We will reverse that S. Okay. Now that S will get modified itself here. Now we have to check that modified S with the previous S. That's why first we have to copy the old contents of this, that S in any other string, and then only we can compare that copied string and the reverse string. In this way we will do. Okay, how? See, first we will accept that source string, like printf enter the string. Now here we will accept that string. Either you can use scanf or you can use gets, anything. Here I am using gets s. Now see, I will reverse, I am going to reverse that S. But before reversing, I will copy the contents of that S into C. Because after calling that strrev, we will get reverse string in that S. And to get the old string, we have to compare with that old string, original string. We will first copy that S inside C. And for that, I have declared one more character array here. Because of this statement, what will happen? Whatever contents of S and whatever contents of C, both will be same. Now we will reverse that S. How? strrevs. Easy. Because of this statement, what will happen here? S will get reversed. And that will be inside. That S will get affected here, will get changed. Now in C, there is a original string. And in S, there is a reverse string. Now we can compare both the strings. How? Again use that strcmp function here. How? If strcmp, which s and c, s comma c equal to 0, then we can say that string is palindrome, otherwise not a palindrome. This is the program to check whether given string is palindrome or not. Here we have first accepted the string. We have copied that string into any other string because we are going to reverse that contents of that string. And after reversing, we will compare the original string and reverse string. If both are same, then strcmp function will return 0. Then we can say that the string is palindrome. Otherwise, string is not a palindrome. Here we have used all the functions, that means at least cpy, rev, cmp functions from the string.h header file. Without using string.h, again you can use some different logic to check whether given string is palindrome or not. See, one more function is there, that is strlwr, to convert the string into lowercase. strupr, uppercase. These are all string oriented functions presenting string.h header file. Okay, like strlen you can use for getting length of string, strcmp to compare two strings, strrev to reverse the string, strcat to concatenate string, strlen to get length of that string. Okay, these are multiple functions available in string.h header file that you can use for string operations. I am going to upload some more programs related with the string concept. Till that, take care. Bye bye. Thank you.